can feel the
fire. All right, here we go.
1, 2, 3, go.
Wow. I love it. Okay, a couple more.
So I'm Yasmine Belkaid, and I work at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease, and we are in the Laboratory of Mucosal Immunology. And we are working essentially on trying to understand how tissue are capable to control infection. And in particular, what we're trying to understand is how the host is capable to defend itself against invasive microbes without destruction of the tissue. In the context of this question, what we're trying to understand is actually how commensals, that are the microbes that live in the surface of the skin or the gut, are controlling immunity to infection. But we're also trying to understand how dietary elements, such as vitamins, are also contributing to immunity. The laboratory is very collaborative, and I'm looking for people that are capable to just work as a team and just work for the common good, really. I'm looking for people that are capable to take risks and start new projects for which we have very little answers.
So I've been studying immunology for since I was an undergrad in college, and I've really been fascinated by the paradox of immunity in the gastrointestinal tract, which is a site which is not only the primary site of infection, but also contains millions upon millions of commensal organisms which share attributes of infections, but yet it lives symbiotically in your gut and actually contributes significantly in a positive fashion to your health.
One of the major problems in the Western world is obviously a lot of conditions that are associated with malfunction of the immune system in the gut. So for example, inflammatory bowel disease.
There's a layer of cells that are literally in the lumen of the gut, which is literally outside of your body, sort of pushing back against the bacteria. And if we deplete those cells, which are called neutrophils, what we see is that structure no longer forms, and what you have is the bacteria have really come into close association with the villi. And in fact, what you can see is that in some cases the bacteria have translocated, or literally moved across the epithelium. And this is generally a bad sign for the host. It means that bacteria is going to be getting into your bloodstream, which is somewhere where we really don't want it to be, and can cause us to become quite sick.
Essentially, what we're using recently is a germ-free facility. That is a facility in which the animals are raised in complete absence of microbes. And what we do is we add very defined microbiota, different microbes, to look at the impact of this microbe on the immune system. So Shruti is actually extracting cells from the skin to try to understand the role of the microbe that live in the skin on the immune system. So what she's going to do is basically extracting the cells within this small machine and isolate them and run them through flow cytometry to look at the function of these cells in the presence or absence of microbes.
Some of the microbes that most people may be familiar with would be staph epidermidis, so it lives on your epidermis, or Propionibacter acnes, which is known to cause acne. And so we're really trying to understand how these bacteria communicate with immune cells and what they do for immunity in the skin.
What I'm really passionate about is not for the money. No.
Definitely not for the money.
I think why are we in research? I can only speak for myself, but I guess just because I really like the idea of trying to figure out how things are interconnected, and just like if I have an idea, I can come to the lab and test it. Most of the time you discover the great things by chance because you're studying something else. It's probably important to keep in mind because it's just like it's not really directed. You can direct it, but then you're very likely to miss important things on the side of the road.
It could be sometimes difficult to actually see the light. Experiment can be long, they can fail. It can take years until we have answers. So I think this part can be really difficult. But I think the collaborative nature of what we do makes it really quite nice to go together in these kind of questions.